Now, members of the Philippine Supreme Court Division reversed their own ruling and clear former First Gentleman Mike Arroyo of graft charges in connection with the purchase of helicopters by the Philippine National Police. Mike Navallo reports.
Former First Gentleman Jose Miguel Mike Arroyo will no longer face a graft charge over his alleged role in the purchase by the Philippine National Police of secondhand helicopters in 2009. That's after a Supreme Court division granted his motion for reconsideration, questioning his inclusion in the case. In a resolution dated December 1, 2021, but released only on April 10 this year, the SC Special Third Division ruled there was no probable cause to charge Arroyo of violating Section 3E of the Anti-Graft and Corrupt Practices Act. The section punishes those causing undue injury to the government or giving any private party unwarranted benefits. Arroyo was accused of helping negotiate the sale of two choppers he owned to the Philippine National Police, despite the National Police Commission's requirement to only buy brand new choppers. In an affidavit, Lion Air owner Archibald Poe claimed he helped Arroyo purchase the choppers from the manufacturer in 2003 and later helped sell it to the PNP through another corporation in 2009. The proceeds, worth around $450,000 for each chopper, supposedly went to Arroyo. Arroyo denied the allegations, saying he was not the owner, and pointed to his deceased brother's company, Lourdes de Arroyo Incorporation, or LTA, as the one who entered into a transaction with the manufacturer. The Supreme Court Special Third Division sided with Arroyo, saying the prosecution failed to establish reasonable belief that Arroyo connived with public officers in procuring the choppers. It faulted the ombudsman and the Sandigan Bayan for assuming that LTA and Mike Arroyo are one and the same, when Arroyo had supposedly divested his LTA shares, and rejected Arroyo and family's frequent use of the choppers as evidence of ownership. The resolution was penned by recently retired Supreme Court Magistrate Rosemary Carandang and concurred in by Justices Rodel Zalameda, Mario Lopez, and Samuel Gerlan, the very same justices who in January 2020 voted with Justice Marvick Leonin to junk Arroyo's petition. In the January 27, 2020 decision penned by Leonin, the same division found no grave abuse of discretion on the part of the Sandigan Bayan and Ombudsman in the exercise of their prerogatives, saying the Supreme Court will not interfere with the findings of probable cause. It is the same reasoning Leonin reiterated in his dissenting opinion to the recent ruling, pointing out that the Ombudsman, in the exercise of his executive function, and the Sandigan Bayan exercising its judicial function, both found probable cause to charge Arroyo and to proceed to trial. Leonin added, misappreciation of facts alone does not amount to grave abuse of discretion, and even considering the facts of the case, there is reasonable belief that Arroyo was involved in the anomalous sale as the owner of the helicopters.
The Philippine Election Commission denies claims that some voters in Dubai and Singapore were given pre-shaded ballots, but the poll body says it will still look into the allegations. This report.
Ating mga kababayan, huwag niyo pong paniniwalaan yung mga pre-shading na sinasabi. Madali pong malaman niya, madali pong makita.
Fake news. That's how the Philippine poll body responded to several allegations of pre-shaded ballots on social media, particularly from overseas absentee voters in Singapore and Dubai. In separate Facebook posts, the voters claimed they received pre-shaded ballots at the embassy and were only handed new ones when they complained. COMELEC Commissioner George Garcia says voters who were given pre-shaded ballots should have rejected the ballots outright and had it noted in the minutes of the voting.
Kapag halimbawa, sabihin na natin totoo na may pre-shading, dapat nakita yun ng una ng watcher. Number one. Number two, meron kasi tinatawag na minutes of voting. Ang tanong ko, yung bang pre-shaded na balota at yung incident na yun, na-report ba yun sa minutes of voting? Kasi kung walang na-report sa minutes of voting, at wala rin nakita yung watcher, wala rin na-object yung watcher, isa lang ibig sabihin, ito totoo yung sinasabi niya.
Still, Garcia says, Task Force Against Fake News will investigate the allegations. He also warns those behind fake news that cyber libel complaints will be filed against them.
Definitely, we will be assigning Commissioner Aimeri to be in charge of the prosecution of all these individuals. Let it be a warning to all that our resolve on this matter is so strong.
The Philippine Embassy in Singapore meanwhile confirms there's one incident wherein a spoiled ballot from Sunday's voting exercise was inadvertently and unintentionally given to a voter Monday morning. But it maintains it was an isolated incident and that it was recorded in the minutes of voting. Overseas voting runs from April 10 to May 9.
Vice Presidential candidate Sara Duterte Carpio speaks out on the pre-shaded ballots in voting precincts abroad. She expressed grave concern on the matter, especially that some reports say it was her name that was pre-shaded in the ballots along with some senatorial candidates. Duterte Carpio reiterates she does not condone or will ever condone cheating, adding that she won her previous post because of fair elections. The Davao Mayor's camp is calling on the COMELEC to investigate on the matter.